shala. It was a libe when good tea. Lit my shala. So the trash. No, can't get shala. So the trash. No, can't get shala. It was a libe when good tea.
Okay, now what I love about this particular song is that just give me an a cappella.
Sugunde clash. Now can sang it clashalamina. Sugunde clash. Now can sang it clashalam. Clashalibu booty. Go. Li clashalam. Li clashalam. Li clashalam mellow.
What does that song mean?
It's one of my favorite songs of my second album. Okay. It's called Sugunde Xesha, which means don't rush me. And the whole chorus, Sugunde Xesha ndawo khansa ngexesha lam. Xesha libekho nguThixo lixesha lam.
Wait, go slow.
It means is don't rush me. Okay. Let me dance in the time that God has set for me to dance. That is the time that God has set for me to, you know, to for my dreams.
Okay.
Yeah.
So come again.
Sugunde Xesha. Don't rush me. Dawu khansa ngexesha lam. I will proceed or dance in my own time. Ixesha elibekwe nguThixo. The time that God has set.
Okay.
Lixesha lam elo. That is the time that I will flourish in.
Wow. I wish I could learn that language.
I'll love teach that. You.
You have to teach me. All right. PM Live Celebrity Edition. Tiz, you're ready to give us the next story?
Yes. So right. Ugandan youths have been urged to embrace productivity to develop the country rather than putting the love for money first. The call was made by the Ambassador of Japan to Uganda, Kazuaki Kameda, during the Ugandan youth beneficiaries under the program of the African Business Education Initiative for Youth. More on that.
African Business Education Initiative for Youth is a program that offers opportunities for young and eligible African men and women to study master's courses in Japanese universities as international students. During the report presentation event, Japanese Ambassador to Uganda cautioned the youth to use the skills acquired productively to develop Uganda.
Within that internship, they found really the core of Japanese business. Like someone says that in Africa, money dictates your work, but in Japan, time dictates. I think that always I'm saying that time is money. Yeah. But for Japan, time is more precious than time, money.
Government representative Isaac Sebulime advised the youth not to wait for the government, but rather to start up something on their own.
You need the factors of production, that you have labor, capital, and land. To me, I've always disputed that, because you can have that. It is not the resources that you have. It is not the land that you have. It is not the natural resources that you have that determine your level of development. And Japan is a living example of this.
The three beneficiaries from Uganda, who are among the 18 representing Africa, presented their report and plans on how to use the skills received from Japan to develop Uganda.
To join such an association and see how we can sensitize the private sector. Okay? They should produce eight items will be checked as because these are officers at the plant, quarantine office. They will check everything that is exported. So the only way of accessing this market is in improving the production.
Most of the trainees were not productive and not efficient on job, and this comes from employability. But however, when I look at Uganda generally, we normally focus on the cognitive skills and technical skills, and we leave the non-cognitive skills, which are the work access skills.
The development also gives them an opportunity of experience and internships in Japanese enterprises in order to develop effective skills and knowledge in various fields for contributing to the development of industries in Africa. While in Japan, youth were skilled in agricultural productivity and engineering under Japan International Cooperation Agency, UGANDA. This report was filed by Das Walugembe for Urban TV.
Thank you, Des Walugembe, for that report. Now, the rate at which Congress weed, a dangerous species of weed, continues to spread in western Uganda has shocked environmental scientists. They say that this weed is not only harmful to lives of animals, but also humans and agricultural output. We have details in this report.
Swaying from side to side, as you reach at Kakumizi in Mbara district where farmers have grown their bean gardens, you could mistake them for flowers. It's almost a decade ever since a Congress weed, an invasive weed believed to have originated from American tropics, was reported in Uganda.
The challenge it has is that apart from being allergic, it is also asthmatic. So when the spores are inherited by a person who is more susceptible to asthma, it complicates the case.
Congress weed, distinguished by white flowers and poisonous chemicals which it produces, used to be in patches in Mbara. But according to National Environment Management Authority, it's now spreading like a bushfire.
We haven't yet known the chemical control of it, and the rate at which it is spreading, it is at an alarming rate. So when it occupies in the gardens and the like, it means even it will be outcompete the agricultural crops.
According to experts, the weed, besides being harmful to both animals and human beings, it outcompetes other edible crops. Now, even Queen Elizabeth National Park is at the risk.
These invasive plants have thorns. They are very aggressive in nature. They grow very fast and form a thicket, excluding animals from the area, totally destabilizing the ecosystem, the natural habitats of these wild animals. So what we are doing, we are using an integrated approach to try and manage the problem. We are using mechanical means. We are using excavators and hoes to manually, mechanically remove these invasive species, heap them in one place and burn them. And then we follow that with the planting of pastures, palatable pastures that these animals can feed on.
Although experts admit that there is no control, they strongly advise farmers to always uproot the weed, dry them, and set them on fire.
In a bid to bridge the gap between male and female app developers in the country, 88 secondary schools have pitched camp in Kol district to generate ideas that help communities. The girls hail from 5 districts of Kole, Lira, Soroti, Kawale, and Gulu, have some amazing app ideas meant to fight alcoholism, early marriage, simplifying learning for the impaired, and ease access to medical services in their communities.
Divided into 19 teams, 88 secondary school girls are gathered in the northern district of Kole to pitch ideas that can lead to community transformation and identify the best young girl app developers in the country.
You find there are a lot of boys creating things and, you know, like having big dreams, but girls are usually not given that chance. So that's why Technovation thought, like, if you we had a program for only girls to compete and try to find ideas or problems in their communities that they can solve, will inspire girls and empower them.
The girls who hail from 5 districts have some amazing apps, among them to fight alcoholism, early marriage, and simplify learning for the visually impaired.
We made a mobile application called Save Me. Save Me has the list of district, and in a person is supposed to choose the district he or she is in, and in that district, the person has chosen, the person will be able to see the hospital around the district, of which in each hospital is the location and also the information about the hospital.
This is the application icon on my phone. So you have to click on it. And when you click on it, this is our first page. You can't get started with us if you don't have an account with us. So you're given an option of logging in and signing up.
Because when we go to the mixed schools, often the girls are, again, underrepresented. And so I think by having an all-girls challenge, they're trying to create a safe space where girls realize that they specifically are being asked. Because often girls think when you ask for people to come and do technology, they just sort of assume that maybe you mean the boys.
Apart from app development, these teenage girls are taught the importance of self-confidence.
When we were starting the program, we reached out to so many schools, but very few of them gave us a positive response. So that was a very big challenge. And also the teachers, they don't have the technical know-how. Yeah, they are willing to support the students, but they don't know the technical bit. So if our mentors don't visit the schools, the students don't make much progress on their project.
Yes, you're watching PM Live Celebrity Edition. My name is Victoria Namutebi Luwaga, and tonight I am hosting Berita all the way from South Africa, though she's Zimbabwean born. Yeah. Yes, so I know we can see the guitar. She's going to be doing an a cappella later on, but time now for the chit chat. And Berita, So is the young, beautiful, talented Afro soul artist single searching ticket? Is she love?
You know, My career is very difficult and very, very demanding.
Okay.
So I can tell you that the last thing I'm thinking about right now
is a relationship.
Is a relationship.
Really?
Yes. Think about it. I've been on the road since Monday. I'm in and out of studios. Mm-hmm. I'm in and out of interviews. Imagine someone calling every 5 seconds.
To say hello.
Say,
how are you?
Hello. You know? Imagine.
Where are you now?
Where are you now?
What are you doing?
What are you doing? I want dinner.
Okay. So in Uganda, we have challenges of sexual harassment the music industry, most especially for upcoming artists who are trying to build their career. Mm. How was it in South Africa?
I can say that I've been very fortunate. I haven't experienced a situation whereby as a woman I have been, you know, sexually harassed, or, you know, sometimes it's implied. I haven't had that kind of a situation. Mm-hmm. But what I would say is that, you know, the most important thing that unfortunately sometimes people miss is don't ever be desperate.
Okay.
People can smell it when you're desperate, unfortunately. If you're desperate to get on TV, desperate to present, desperate to dance, if you're just desperate to be famous, then you're positioning yourself in the wrong way, you know. But also, what I've found works for me is that I tend to associate myself with a lot of women in the industry and share my story with them. I've had challenges in terms of business, in terms of travel, in terms of working with different people, because sometimes us females are very emotional.
Mm.
But if you have another female, for example, Mami Von Chaga Chaga is my mentor.
Oh,
so
wow.
If I'm having a challenge, then I'm able to talk to her.
Mm.
So you want to make sure as a female, you always have someone that you can talk to.
Oh, wow. Mm. Quite interesting there. And now time for the a cappella.
You said you want something you can sing to
as
well. Yes. You know Malaika, Mos?
No.
Malaika.
Oh.
Nakupenda.
Malaika. Oh, my God.
Malaika. Nakupenda. Malaika. Namini fanyinje kijana mwenzio nashindwa na mali sina ningekuoa malaika nashindwa na mali sina wewe ningekuoa malaika ningekuwa malaika.
Wow. Go to our social media pages, write our celebrity anchor. Another song.
Oh, okay. Let me play you. This one is called Ezizweni, which means overseas.
Okay.
Okay. It's about, you know, your lover taking you to
fancy places. That one. I like that one already.
Undibega. Undibega. Feels so good. Feels really, really good. Be in your arms tonight. You're a busy man, always on the move. We never have time. Chest to chest we lay close. Heart to soul, that's where it goes. That's where it goes. Ooh. Undita undibega. Undibega. As in swimming. Undita undibega. Undibega. As in swimming. Looking into your eyes, so tempted to kiss and tell the world. You hold me like a treasure, you leave no room for escape. Undi tundi be.
I wish I knew this song. Yeah? Okay.
Undibega, as it swim me. Chest to chest we lay close. Heart to soul, that's where it goes.
Okay.
That's where it goes.
Chest to chest we lay together. That's what I had. Eh?
Yes. Chest to chest we lay close. Heart to soul. That's where it goes. That's
okay.
Where it goes.
Okay, so before we go into our feedback, just a few questions.
Yeah.
How do you manage to sing with this emotion, with this love, yet you're not in a relationship?
Well, I have been in relationships before. Oh. Like, I wrote the song when I was in a relationship.
Oh.
Yeah, but it didn't work out.
Okay, one more question. We saw you do collabs with Olivia Mutukuzi from Zimbabwe and
yes.
Masekele, rest in peace, from South Africa. How did this boost your career?
Oh, it was the best, actually the best opportunity that I was presented with in my career, because I got to do a song with two legends that have ever done a song, one song together before.
Mm-hmm.
And they'd always wanted to. They were really good friends. They had known each other for 30 years.
Whoa.
But the first time that they ever collaborated was on my song.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also just spending a lot of time with Brahuma Segela before he passed away, I learned a lot about music and, you know, being an artist and just being a free spirit and letting the music take you where it needs to take you. And of course, with Baba Oliver Mtukuzi, I always learn about, you know, to reflect the times of what's going on in my community.
Mm.
And even to travel right now, because he travels a lot around Africa.
So you really learned
so
a lot from
I
them.
I learn a lot from them. Yeah.
Wow. We asked you to go to our social media pages, at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook, to write the celebrity anchor and also ask those questions that you wanted to answer tonight. It's now time to get into your feedback.
Woo! All right.
Sekam JMC Aliwali, is there any connection between Zahara and her? The connection and music style is kind of the same. Can she do me an a cappella of Loliwe? I give her 10 out of 10. Wow, her music is my favorite.
Yay, thank you so much. Thank
10
you for
out
the
of 10.
So Zahara is like a sister to me, hey?
Oh.
Where I studied in the Eastern Cape is where she's from.
Okay.
Yes, and you know, I consider her my big sister. She released her first album with Loliwe before I even started making music, and she's someone that I truly love and respect.
Oh, so you'll give us the a cappella after the feedback.
I do not know, like, I don't know how to play the chords for that song, but it's a beautiful song and I love it very much.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Then Khashoggi, Zavi Blaze, wow, she has a good voice. I'm getting you from Arua City. Wow, he's watching from Arua.
Thank you, Khashoggi, but I wish you'd given me a 10.
And he's saying, how can I access your songs?
Oh, yes. So my music is available. Mm-hmm. As you know, people listen a lot to music now on the internet. So okay. Just Google my name on the internet. Mm-hmm. You can go to YouTube. If you have access to Apple Music, you can go there. Spotify, Deezer. I'm not sure in terms of, you know, what is available and in where, you know, he's from. But the best place to go is actually on my website, which is www.buritaafrosoul.co.za.
All right. And he gave you 8 out of 10.
Thank you,
Ochan. Which is a high score, by the way.
Thank
you. Now, Ochan Jackmo, I love the beauty and jolliness. I give her 8 out of 10. Big up.
Yay. Thank you.
Agawa Nicholas, wow. Perfect anchor, 9 out of 10. She ought to have done journalism.
It's my first time, so I can understand if I'm gay. I'm very competitive. So, you know, that's one point I wanted.
Okay, more feedback. Blight writer, she's real. I wish I could make a collaboration with her.
Send me your music on Twitter. I want to hear it.
More feedback. Abdurrahman, I'm watching you live straight away from Namugongo. Thank you for watching the
show. Thank you for the love from Namugongo. Thank you.
Irene Ayevare, English, good. I give her 9 out of 10.
Irene, that one point, how?
Agawa Nicholas, management of Urban TV should employ her immediately.
I've got a job in Uganda. Yeah!
With just one interview.
You know? Lucky me.
All right, well, keep the feedback coming on our social media pages at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook. And I have enjoyed the show. I don't know about you.
Thank you so much, my friend.
Meanwhile, how would you rate yourself?
You know, to be quite honest, I was stumbling when I was reading. Okay. But because I came with music, I'll give myself a 10.
Oh, out of 10. Well, I'll give you 100 out of 10.
Yay! Thank you.
All right. Any other message for your fans?
I just want to say thank you so much. Okay. I've really enjoyed my time in Kampala, Uganda. Mm-hmm. It's been amazing. I'm truly, truly humbled. You know, today I got a present, by the way, from one of my favorite fans, Morris, from Kampala.
Okay.
The other day I was given earrings. Wow. So I've been getting gifts, and I've been getting a lot of messages on my Twitter and my Facebook and Instagram. Mm-hmm. And for that, I'm eternally grateful. I will be back again soon to give you a show. So
we'll be waiting for you. And that's it for PM Live Celebrity Edition. Thank you for watching. Follow Berita on Instagram.
Yes. At Berita Afrosoul, B-E-R-I-T-A Afrosoul. And on Twitter, same handle, at Berita Afrosoul. Facebook, Berita Afrosoul. Looking forward to your comments. Follow me on Twitter. I'll follow you back.
Hey.
Yeah, that's my Twitter special.
All right. Also, show me some love. Victoria Namutebi on Twitter, Victoria Namutebi on Facebook. Thank you for watching PM Live Celebrity Edition. Have yourselves a blessed Saturday evening. Let's meet again tomorrow at 8 p.m. Anytime now,